In this video, we're going to go through some JavaScript practice exercises for beginners where I give you a problem and then we go through the solution together. Hi, this is James from Junior Developer Central and welcome to these JavaScript practice exercises. In the video, what's going to happen is I'm going to present you with a problem which can be solved with JavaScript, and then what I'd like you to do after each problem is actually pause the video and go away and have a bit of a go at coding it yourself and see what kind of solution you can come up with. If you have a second, don't forget to subscribe to support the channel below and so that you don't miss out on any future tutorial updates. So now let's get started with our first exercise. Okay, so this first one is nice and simple. It's a classic write a function to take some numbers and do something with them and return true or false, depending on the outcome. So for this one, we want to write a JavaScript program to check two numbers and return true if one of the numbers is 100, or if the sum of those two numbers is actually 100 as well. So right now, if you pause the video and go to your console or text editor and then try and solve this challenge, and if you get stuck or you want to see the solution, then come back in just a second where I'll show you how I would solve it. Okay, so the way I'd approach this is basically to first of all write a function, and I'm just going to do a function declaration. So we're using ES6 here, and one of the features which is arrow functions. So by doing this sort of syntax, I can basically create a function without having to actually use the function keyword. So with my function, I'm going to accept those two numbers that kind of come in. So A, I'm just call those A and B. And the first thing I'm going to do is say is A equal to 100. And now I'm using the triple equals to make sure that it's definitely a number that's been passed in as an argument. So this will check the first number. So the other thing I need to do is check the second number. So I'm going to just use an OR operator here to say is A equal to 100 or is B equal to 100 as well. So if I just call that a couple of times to see if it's doing what it's supposed to be doing. Okay, yeah, so we can see that if A or B is passed in as 100, then we get a true value. But what about if we pass in some values which aren't 100? So let's pass in two tens instead. You can see I get false values back, so that's all good. That's working as it's expected. But what happens if I pass in two numbers that actually do add up to 100? And that's the final part of the exercise. So here I've passed in 20 and 80 and 50 and 50. So because neither of those numbers are 100, the last two console log statements actually give us false. So we need to amend our function slightly so that it accepts that final condition of the actual exercise definition. So we can just put in another OR statement and then just, if we just basically add A and B together and then say, is A and B together, does that actually equal 100 as well? Well, if it does, then we want to return true. And when we run the code again, you can see those last two console logs actually give us true values as well. So that's how I'd approach exercise one. And as you can see, you can use a one-line arrow function to just do those OR statements. If you had a larger function that has like if statements inside as well, that's fine. That's a logical way to solve it. Just to keep things nice and short, this is probably the easiest way to get the same result. So that's exercise one. Let's move on to exercise two. So exercise 2 is another nice and simple one, and it's basically to write a JavaScript program to get the extension of a file name. So if you think about the extension of a file name, so we're talking about the .html or the .js, so everything after the dot at the end of the actual file name. So pause the video again, go ahead and give it a try, and I'll see you in a second when you come back for the solution. Here's how I would solve exercise 2. So I'm just going to create another function again, and I'll just call it get file extension, for example. And again, I'll use an arrow function here, and we're just going to pass in a string into that. So the string could be any file name that we want to get the extension of, and the string could be any file name that we want to get the extension of, and we only want to get the last portion of the string. So I'm going to say string.slice, which the slice function just gives us a portion of an actual string. So as you can see for the documentation for slice, we need to pass it in a start number and optionally an end number as well. So the start number we want to pass in is actually the last occurrence of the dot in the actual string that we're trying to work out the file extension for. So I'm just going to say string.lastIndexOf, and this function basically looks through the string and just gives us the position of the last occurrence of whatever string I put within the parentheses here. So obviously I'm going to put in a dot in here to actually find the last occurrence of that in that string. And that should pretty much do it for this exercise. So if I do a console.log just to test that out, and I'll say get file extension, and the string I'll pass in, I'll just say index.html. And if we run that in the console now, and as you can see in the console, we've got the .html extension extracted from the actual string. So let's run that one more time with just a trickier example. So this time I'm going to use a common file that's found in a lot of web development repositories, which is the webpack config. And as you can see, it's got two dots in the actual file name, but we only want to get the .js extension. And when we run that code, you can see that because we've used last index of for the string, we've only got the last occurrence of the dot, so just returning the last couple of characters. So that's it for this exercise. Let's move on to exercise 3. Now, this is a bit of a classic one. It's asking you to write a program to basically take a string and every character in that string just to shift it forward one letter in the alphabet. And there's a couple of ways of doing this, but I'll let you pause the video now and have a go at coding this up. And I'll see you in a few minutes where we go through the solution that I've come up with. Okay, I hope you got on okay with that exercise. So to solve this, you can create a string that has all of the alphabet in and then kind of compare the string that you're working with and shift it forward in that array. But probably a more elegant approach is to use a couple of functions that are built into JavaScript. First of all, the string.fromCharCode and also the charCode at function as well. So I'll show you how to use these in just a second. Let's create a function first of all though. So I'll call this move chars forward, for example. You can call it whatever you like. And we're going to pass in a string to that. And what we're actually going to do is, because we want to actually modify the contents of the string, I'm going to split it into an array. So I'm going to call the split function on the string, which basically returns every character in the string as an array. And because we now have an array, I can call another function on here as well. I'm just going to move this onto another line just so that we can easier to read. I'm actually then going to call the map function. So if you haven't used the map function before, it basically mutates an array, which basically means it changes every item in the array depending on what you pass in as the function. So for each character that's in the array, I'm going to pass it back to a function. And for each function, I'm going to say use that string.fromCharCode. So what this actually does is takes a numerical code which represents the string and converts it back into an actual character, into a string. So we need to pass that an actual value. So what I'm going to do is for the char that we've got, which is still a string as well, I'm going to actually access the charCode at function, which basically returns the numerical value that we need. So this would literally just give us the character back. We've converted it into a number and then back into a string. But because we've got the number here, we can actually just add one onto it, which will have the effect of actually just pushing it through the alphabet by one. So the last thing we need to do, because we've got our string split into an array, we want to actually join it back together to make a string. And now that will return our string, which has had letters in the alphabet themselves shifted forward one time. So let's test that out. Okay, so you can see when we pass in A, B, C, D, they're shifted forward one character each by B, C, D, E. So whilst this solution does work really well, there's only one problem with it. If we actually pass in the end of the alphabet, so a Z, in this example, you can see it doesn't give us an A as the expected result. And because the exercise isn't clearly written what should happen when we've moved it forward, it probably should really return an A. So we probably need to put some conditions or some if statements in there to, if the number is above a certain value, then to actually go back to the start and give us an A. But I'm going to leave this exercise as it is for the moment, just to demonstrate how I would approach this particular exercise. So that's it for this exercise. Let's move on to exercise 4. So exercise 4 is a really common scenario, especially because JavaScript dates don't work in the fashion that they do in other programming languages, and they can be a little bit difficult to work with. So this exercise is basically asking you to take the current date and print it out in one of the expected formats. So pause the video again and have a go at this one, and I'll see you in a few moments when you've got your solution. Okay, I hope you got on all right with that one, and I'm just going to dive straight in on the solution that I came up with. So I'm just going to create the function to do this. So we'll say format date, and I will allow it to pass in another date variable as well. So we could use any other date objects that we might have in JavaScript. But the first thing I'm going to do is just create a new date object, which basically gets a date object for right now when I'm running this code. And for this function, it's going to be a bit more in-depth, so I'm going to open it up so it's not a one-liner in this case. So the first thing I'm going to do is get the day of the month that we're currently on at the moment. And to do that, I'm going to say const days is equal to the date. So this is a date object, so there's some methods available on it. And I'm going to say get day, which basically gives us the day of the month that we want to display. And I'm going to do the same thing for months and years. And you'll notice that the year's one's slightly different. It's get full year to get the four characters of the year. And all I'm going to do now is just return a template literal, which is basically just a string with some values inside it as well. So I'm going to say days, and I'll use forward slash, and then finally years as well. So here in the UK, we put our days first, so it's days, months, and years. So let's just run that code now and see what we get back. And if I don't pass in any values, the default value of a new date object will be created, so we don't actually need to pass anything into that for it to work. Okay, so it did give us a result in the output, but what we're actually looking at here is, you're not to know this, but it's actually February when this is being recorded, so it's actually the second month, and the reason for that is we need to just add one onto those values, because they're zero indexed, so zero will be the actual first month, i.e. January. And I've actually made a mistake there, it's not get day, it's get date, and that gives us the day of the month, so 13th of the second, that looks good. So as I say, working with JavaScript dates is a little bit tricky, and you need to use these functions to kind of get the values for each particular day of the month and the month itself. But this is probably a simple way of doing it, and it's quite flexible because we can pass in other date objects as well. So that's it for this exercise. Let's have a look at our final one, which is exercise 5. Okay, so for exercise 5, we need to write a simple program that creates a new string and actually prepends at the word new at the front of the actual string. So if we had, say, offers as passed in as a string, it would then say new offers. But if the string has already got like the new at the start of it, then we shouldn't actually add that on, and it should just leave it as it is and return the original string. So one last time, if you pause the video and go ahead and give this a crack, and I'll see you in a few seconds when you've got your solution. Okay, so probably the best way to approach this again is to use a template literal to put the string new before our existing string, but we do need to have that check in place to see if the actual word new is at the start of our string. So let's create a new function to do that. So we've got a basic function, add new, and it's got passing in an argument, which is a string. So the simplest thing to do would just be to return a template literal like this, and then just pass the string back afterwards. So that pretty much solves the first part of the problem. Let's just demonstrate that. Okay, you can see in the console on the right, we're getting new offers. But of course, if we already had new in there, we'd get new offers. So we need to have that check in place to see if the string is already in the base string. So I've just updated the function and I've put it on the line below just so it's a bit easier to read. So we've just got that check in place now to say, is the index of new? So does the word new appear at the first part of the string? So we're checking if that index of is equal to zero. And if it is, the ternary operator kicks in and we just return back the original string. But if it's not, so it could be somewhere else in the string, but it's just not right at the start, we return back the template literal with new prepended at the start. And as you can see, the code's run and the string has been updated to not actually put in new in twice. So that's probably the easiest way to approach this exercise, a nice one-liner, and it's a good example of when you might use a ternary operator rather than an if statement. So that is it for these exercises. They're fairly beginner exercises, but hopefully you found some of them useful and got some value out of the going through the solutions. Just before you go, don't forget to subscribe to support the channel and for any future updates. And I'll see you in the next video for some more JavaScript coding exercises.